Put your needles in there. Take care of yourself, huh?
Yeah, thanks.
How you feeling?
Rough. I think I got an infection.
You want to see our medical officer?
No. That's all right. Maybe later.
Let me tell her you need to see her. I'll ask her.
Wake up. You can't sleep here. Better be gone when I come back. They let us sleep in once in a while.
Yeah.
You don't happen to know whether there's any work, do you?
No, not really. What do you do?
I'm a school teacher. Teach history.
Yeah? Not a lot of call for that these days, I guess, huh?
Well, I can't say that again.
You ever do construction?
Oh, I worked on one of the dams when I was a kid. I can bang nails, whatever.
Yeah, I know of a lumber yard down the road. You can pick up the job once in a while.
Yeah?
Yeah, I can give you a lift on my way to work if you want.
That'd be great. Thanks.
Sure.
Hey, you don't happen to have a cigarette, do you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, help yourself.
Oh, thanks, man. It's okay. It's your last one.
That's okay. Take it.
Oh, thanks. You sure? I'll save it for later.
How's your vision?
Seems okay.
Ow. Well, have you seen a doctor?
No, I'm going in a little while.
It doesn't look too bad to me, but I'm not a doctor. You should see a doctor.
I just wanted you to take a look, just in case you didn't believe me.
Well, of course I believe you.
They broke my glasses. It's my only pair.
When did this happen?
Last night, about 9:30.
Hold it.
We were set up outside Carnegie Center.
Yeah.
You know, giving away free needles like we always do.
Right.
And then the cops turn up.
How many cops?
Well, I don't know. 5, maybe 6.
Really?
They all just kind of rushed in, turned over the tables, busted maybe 3 guys who were holding. You know, guys who came to get new needles.
Yeah.
Then they stomped all over the needles like some kids throwing a tantrum.
It's like the third or fourth time, isn't it?
Third time this month.
This month?
People are going to stop coming to get needles.
I think that's kind of the point. You didn't get any badge numbers.
No, I told you already.
Look, I don't really think I'm going to get anywhere with this. Holy, I got the same prescription pretty much.
Those look good on you.
You think so?
Maybe we should swap.
Yeah, okay. Actually, yeah, hold on to those. You give yourself another pair and then you can return those to me.
Hey, thanks.
Just don't bend those frames, okay? I love those. You can't get those anymore.
I'll drop them by your office.
Perfect. Oh, hey, do you know Phil Rosen?
No.
The lawyer?
Phil.
Okay, go and see him, okay? His office just down here on Main Street. You can't miss it. Where the cop shop is and go down to the end. Okay?
Okay.
You go in there and tell him the story just the way you told me. And go down to the cop shop with him and fill out a police report, okay?
Phil Rosen.
Phil Rosen, great guy. Okay, so you're going to see a doctor and you're going to see Phil Rosen.
Yeah. Okie dokie, Dominic.
Okie dokie. Take care of yourself.
Yeah, you too.
A few skinny girls that work this corner.
Yeah, well, this one's name is Sue. That ring a bell?
Sue. I think so, from Kamloops.
That's her.
What do you want with her?
Has she been around lately?
Not lately, no.
Has she been sick or anything like that?
I just know that she hasn't been around in maybe 3 weeks. Maybe she took a vacation. I don't know. You could ask her boyfriend.
Who's he again?
He works at a used record store in Hastings.
Right. Okay, well, if you see her, tell her that I want to talk to her.
Yeah, okay.
Hey.
Hey, Leo, how's it going?
Good. Hey, Trisha, what's the omelet today?
It's shrimp.
I'll take the Denver.
Coffee?
Yeah.
Thanks, that was good.
I have shrimp for breakfast. I burp it up all day.
Hey, how's that TV working out for you?
Good. I put it in the bedroom.
Hmm?
How's your change working out?
Changes? So far, so good, I guess. We'll see.
Hey, Mick.
Hey, Rose. Just leave it. You want to sit down?
Hey, thanks for the toaster oven.
Yeah, you bet. Catch you guys later.
See you. Mick gave you his toaster oven?
Yeah, said he was moving, getting rid of some stuff. I needed a new one, so.
Yeah, gave me a TV set and a couple of lamps. He's giving away everything he owns.
Yeah, I did the same thing once. You know, didn't want to move all my stuff, so I bought new stuff, had it delivered.
Yeah, but he's not doing that. He's living in his truck.
In his truck?
Yeah.
Well, that doesn't sound good. Thanks.
I don't know what it is. I guess it's something that he's got to figure out for himself.
Yeah. Didn't he break up with his girlfriend a while back, the pathologist?
Yes, honey. They broke up.
Yeah, Mick's been kind of messed up since that shooting.
Yeah. That's what I'm kind of worried about. I'm thinking, like, this, you know, might all have something to do with that.
You should say something to Angie. She could keep an eye out.
I did. I gave her a heads up.
Hmm.
Well, what's the point of having a needle exchange program if your police hooligans are going to come in there once a week and bust the place up?
I didn't hear about that.
Yeah. They're resorting to the same intimidation tactics again, and unfortunately, they work pretty good. Now, the people manning the needle exchange program are starting to get pretty upset. You know, they're entitled to police protection like anybody else, and they're starting to feel like they need protection from the protection.
You know, I get a lot of calls from people all the time about how they're upset when their friends and family come to Vancouver and they have to run the gauntlet of dealers and panhandlers if they want to go down to that area. Or Gastown, or Chinatown, the cruise ships.
Yeah, well, I'm not that happy about people having to do all their business out in the street either.
No, it's not just the addicts. I mean, it's the prostitutes, too.
Well, you know, the sex trade, the drug trade, they're not going anyplace. Now, we agree on that, don't we? All right, so either we keep on doing what we're doing, which is hiring more and more police, keep pushing the addicts and the hookers further along Hastings Street or the Granville Mall or wherever, or we sit down, we develop a strategy which is going to actually address the problem.
So what do you want? I mean, what would be at the top of your wish list?
I'd set up a supervised safe injection site right away and get it running. That way, there's a safe place for the addicts to shoot. We can expose them to the various health programs that are available for them and like that. That look, they're off the street corner, makes your citizens happy, and these guys have a safer environment.
Oh, sorry. Safe injection sites. All right.
All right?
If I help you with that, will you do something for me?
Absolutely, of course.
Yeah, I got to clean up the police force. We got a major problem down there. It's out of control.
Well, that's exactly what I've been trying to tell you. What have you got in mind?
Well, I got a meeting coming up with the police board. We're coming up on the end of the current chief's tenure, so either we offer him a new contract or search around for a better candidate, you know, someone who can bring this city forward.
I'm 100% behind you on that one, too.
Good. So this candidate obviously has to be somebody with policing experience, you know. Somebody who knows the city, knows the problems, and preferably somebody with a bit of a profile.
Yeah, who'd you have in mind?
I'm looking at him.
You have the background for it. The mayor thinks he can sell you to the police board.
Boy, it's a pretty big piece of business for me to bite off. You know, I've got enough enemies to last me like two lifetimes out there. It's got to be the most thankless job on the planet.
Just think about it. If you have any questions, call me, please.
Well, I'll definitely be thinking about it.
In the meantime, I'll fax you a list of city properties. You let us know which ones you think might work for a safe injection site.
Boy, oh boy, I sure didn't expect this. What's your name again?
Claire.
Claire.
Yeah, yeah. Hey, oh, hey, Helen. Hi, yeah. Listen, police board, I want to know who the, who's on that police board. Could you find that out for me in some backgrounders? The police board. Right, hey, hold on a second, my other cell phone. Yeah, that's me. Yeah, okay. Helen, just hold on. Okay, I'm coming, all right? All right, you're right there. Bye. Got my glasses? Oh, great.
Yeah, what happened to your other glasses?
Oh, listen, I'm expecting a really important fact from the mayor's office regarding possible safe injection sites.
Uh-huh.
What's this? Oh, great, that's it.
Yeah, that's a federal thing. You need the feds on board for that.
I know.
They said that the city can approve in principle when it comes to the distribution of a controlled substance. That's federal.
Well, no, there's no distribution going on. People are bringing their own dope. It's no different from damn needle exchange.
I gotta take this.
Well, who do I have to see?
Minister of Health, I guess. What happened to your other glasses?
I think there was somebody. Well, can I get right in there and see the minister? We must know somebody in there.
No, okay. I'll get on it.
Okay.
So, hey, what brought the mayor around?
What?
Well, how come he's back in the injection sites now?
Oh, I don't know. I'm just glad he is, though.
Well, maybe he's not gonna run again.
I don't know. He never said anything to me about running.
All right.
Or
well,
running or anything. What's that?
It's the list of directors on the police board.
Excellent.
I need those.
I need it. Thank you, Helen. Excellent.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
Oh, I'll read anything if I can't sleep.
What turned you on to this stuff? What's it called?
It's called The Narrow Road to the Deep North. Basho. He was a poet in Japan, 1600s. And anyway, he lost his house in this fire, right? He lost everything in it. And he suddenly realized that the only thing he had left was himself. And he thought, he got this idea that if he walked far enough, maybe he could lose that too. So he walked and he walked maybe a couple hundred miles all over Japan, visited different monasteries, things like that, and then he wrote about it.
And did he? Well, did he ever lose himself?
I don't know. I haven't finished it yet. Get lost on the road a couple times, I guess that's losing yourself.
Yeah, I guess it is. My brother was in a monastery.
Really?
Yeah, someplace in Idaho now. But I don't hear from them too often. They take a vow of silence.
You know, I'm thinking that's just about probably the hardest vow to keep.
Would be for me. I'm on the phone for 5 minutes, I hang up, it's an hour later.
Yeah, I don't like the phone too much. You can't see the people's eyes. You can't see their gestures. You don't notice all the tells and giveaways.
Hmm. Never thought about it. I guess you're right.
Letters are more intimate. People don't write letters anymore, though.
You write a letter, you get to edit yourself. That's not letting the person see your eyes right there.
I haven't written a letter in a long time, man. I used to have a pen pal in Mexico.
Yeah? I had a pen pal in Greece. I always wondered what happened to her.
Mine started asking me for money, so I started loading up the quarters into the envelope, sending in my allowance. And the old man came in and caught me doing it one day, and that was just about all I wrote.
Someone's gonna be by to talk to you real soon, all right?
Make sure Victim Services gets here sometime today, okay? Jeez, I called half an hour ago.
They're on their way.
Yeah, we'll tell them to step on it. Hey, Angie, Mick.
Hey, Suki, what's going on? Hey, where's Brian?
I don't work with him anymore. I got bumped from vice up to robbery.
No kidding. Hey, congratulations on both counts. You must be thrilled leaving him behind.
Yeah, apparently there is a God after all.
So what's going on here?
Oh, it looks like a grow house rep. They got about 5 kilos of bud just ready to harvest. This lady, Tam Tam, she rents. Lives upstairs, so she doesn't know a thing about the grow up in the basement.
That's the usual response. Complete denial.
Flashlight?
So what went down?
Thanks.
About 3-4 a.m. this morning, her back door gets kicked in. Her son, who lives with her, he catches a 2x4 in the head. He's in the hospital, hasn't regained consciousness. Who knows if he will or what kind of condition he's going to be in if he does.
You got a line on the landlord?
He lives in Hawaii. We're tracking him down.
How many guys?
2, sounds like. So they kick in the door upstairs here, conk the son, grab Tam, try to force her to give up the key, which she already said she didn't have. So they push her around a bit for that, and then get this, decide to rape her.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, so they do their stuff, then on the way out, they decide to give the basement one more try. They get the door open upstairs here. Come on down. Watch it. The stairs are steep.
Oh, I could smell it from here.
Yeah, it reeks. It was like flies to honey.
Yeah, they knew it was ripe, so somebody had inside information.
Nothing happens without somebody ratting out somebody else.
So there you go. Must have caught a hell of a jolt, scorched his boot, burned his hand there.
He raped that woman and stepped right into hell.
Yeah, he got his.
So it's a booby trap or what?
I called forensics to go over it. They're on their way. Should be safe for now. The hydro guy's already been here, secured the juice. See that water on the floor? That's an irrigation line that was leaking.
Yeah. Did she give you a description of the other guy?
Just like this one. Skinhead, mid-20s, white. I couldn't figure if this ranked as a homicide or what.
How you doing?
Yeah, okay. It's pretty ripe. You might want to hold your nose.
Really? How long has it been since somebody saw her?
Church, about a week ago.
A week.
Then apparently some friends from the congregation tried to phone, couldn't get through.
Oh.
It was the gardener who finally found her. Just working on the gutters here. Saw her through the window in bed, couldn't rouse her.
Is he still around?
No, he had to go do some other jobs, but I got his number.
Is she in here?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It looks like she died pretty peacefully. Just kind of slipped away.
Blood thinners. Maybe she's a stroke victim. Walker. Maybe she had another stroke.
Look here. The phone was off the hook.
That's how it was when you found her?
Mm-hmm. Her friends couldn't get through.
You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Step outside if you have to. Okay. Show another picture.
I heard Rose was getting kicked up to homicide. So I got my ass on down to robbery. Took the exam, just got lucky. That's the way to do it. You gotta hustle. I thought maybe you had something to do with it. You had a good word for me, maybe? Hey, you got a friend somewhere, I guess.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Nick, sorry I'm late.
Yeah, Chick, no problem. I'll take you in.
You don't.
So, what about Brian? See him anymore?
Not if I can help it.
He's got a new partner. She's gonna get totally sucked up, and you can tell. What's her name?
From Drug Squad. Marla something or other.
Marla?
She's a player.
What do you mean?
She's a hustler. Like Brian. Likes to party with the boys, you know?
Not much in the fridge. Half a quart of lemonade, some pickles and that.
Not much in the cupboards either. Baking powder, flour.
Cupboards are pretty bare. Oh, except for the freezer. Look, she's got a bunch of meals in here. 5 or 6 of them anyway. Kind of look homemade, too.
Yeah, must have her meals delivered. You know how they do that?
Oh, yeah. What is that? That smell?
Lemon, you mean?
Yeah.
Air freshener?
You spray it?
No, not me.
There's a friend of hers outside.
Oh, great. I'll be right there. Okay. Okay, keep poking around.
Okay.
That mailbox completely full. No one's picking up the mail for her.
This is Mrs. Franks. She's a friend from church.
Mrs. Franks?
Mm-hmm. This is the coroner. She's just got a couple of questions for you.
How do you do? My condolences. You can call me Dominic.
Thank you. Pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. When was the last time you saw your friend, Mrs. Ripley?
Well, I was away for a while. 6 weeks, I guess.
Oh, yeah?
Somebody came and got her at the home and took her down to the picnic at Stanley Park.
And how was she then?
Oh, she was her usual.
Oh, yeah.
She was lively. She liked to sing. She was always singing off-key, but she enjoyed it. I think people should be allowed to sing off-key if they want.
Boy, me too. I know I do.
I'm lucky I've got a good voice. I'm in the choir.
Well, you are lucky. Now, when you say that somebody came by the home and picked her up and took her to the park, who was that?
Well, not here. The place she was staying before she moved back here.
Oh, she's in a care facility.
Well, till they moved her out. Her doctor would know all about that.
Yeah, well, her doctor, we're having a kind of a hard time locating him. I understand that she had a limited mobility.
She was paralyzed on the one side. Her right, I think. Yes, she was paralyzed on the right side.
Okay. Well, I can't think of any more questions for you. I really appreciate you telling me this. Could you just give your number, though, to the officer in case we need something more? Okay.
At least she died at home.
Yeah, she got that. Thanks again. Hi, Helen. Yeah, it's me. Listen, I'm experiencing a spike in elderly deaths over here on the west side. Could you run some numbers for me? Just seeing way too many of them.
So, you open the door and that motion sensor there behind you turns on the current. And you got this metal pipe handrail here that's hooked up to it. That's what burned his hand there, see?
Yeah, these stairs are pretty steep. He would have had to have grabbed that handle.
Yeah, well, just in case he didn't, these metal stairs here are gonna conduct too. So, right away, you got the full jolt. It would have knocked him right down the stairs. Mm. And because of the leak on the floor here, all this water is alive too. So he lands in the pool of water. If he ain't dead already, he is now because he fries right up.
So it's a homicide then?
Yep, that's pretty much for sure. You know, a lot of these grow-ups got homemade security systems. Money's just too big not to, huh? It's just up here.
Okay, how does that work? Right. Yeah, well, once a day. How much does that cost? Okay, no, he's off the paper. Lucky. Right, okay, I'll get a key made for you. Thanks. Dog walker.
You got a dog?
I got a puppy from the pound.
Oh, what kind?
He's a 57. Mostly terrier, I think. He's got that wiry kind of fur. The vet says they don't shed too much.
You hope. The mixes are the best, though. They're smarter.
Really?
How big?
I think it's going to be about, you know, yay high. You can tell by their feet. He's going to be a little guy.
And my aunt had a little dog, lap dog. Pick it up, it'd shake all over and pee on you. Bark at the TV, the walls, your shoes, anything.
Well, this guy's not going to be like that. He's really nice and quiet. That's why I picked him. Lucky, that's his name.
You name him?
No, that's what they were calling him down at the pound. He was scheduled to be put down, and then I showed up, so it fits. So your aunt's the little dog, has she still got him?
Oh, he got run over.
Oh. Gee, that's a shame.
Yeah, my aunt was really busted up about it, too. And then I felt bad because I never liked him.
Hey, thanks a lot. Now, it just seems like I'm on my fourth or fifth call here this year. It's old folks dying at home. Everything's not quite right in there.
Well, you know what it is. It's the hospital cutbacks and extended care and all that crap. They send them back home, and guess what happens? They die.
Okay, that's the theory, Leo. I hope that's not the case here, but I don't know. It's worth taking a look. The older I get, the more suspicious I get. You know what I mean?
Who's taking care of this lady?
Not sure. We're trying to get hold of her doctor.
When's the last time anybody was in here?
We're trying to get a hold of the gardener, too. He's the guy that found her, so.
Hey, Rose, you see a thermostat around there anywhere?
Yeah, here we go.
What's it say?
75. She's old. She likes it warm.
That soil is still wet. There's no way, sitting on top of the radiator like that for a week, that could still be wet, so somebody had to be in here.
Where'd you pick that up?
I killed more plants than anybody.
Okay, you want to look in the bedroom? Rose? Morning.
Ooh. She used the walker, huh?
Yeah. She's partially paralyzed.
Well, so she places the walker over there in the corner and hops back into bed? I don't think so. Somebody move that walker.
What's this medicine here?
Blood thinners. You know, after a stroke, that prevents blood clots.
Can we take these covers off?
Oh, yeah, sure. I got my pictures.
Her feet haven't been cared for in a while. Her toenails are curling. I don't think she's been mobile either.
Bed soiled.
Well, if she was bedridden, that means somebody had to have moved that walker.
Yeah. Well, maybe nothing, but I'm glad to have the extra set of eyes on this. I'm going to send her into autopsy.
Could be she was just forgotten to death.
Don't even worry about that guy. We'll just go in there. Hey, Suki.
Hey.
Marla, Suki, you guys know each other, right?
Yeah, we went through training together.
How you been?
Good.
You?
Good. Good.
Listen, Marla, you mind grabbing us a couple of lattes?
Sure. Anything to snack?
No, I'm good. You want coffee? Marla's good.
No, I'm good. Thanks.
Just working with it.
Wait, your new partner's not working out? I thought you two were made
oh,
for
no,
each other.
Oh, no, she's fine. She's great. Just, I'm just looking at you. Really.
Thanks. I got some stuff.
Listen, I just wanted to tell you, you know, the whole time I was working with you, you know, I was always trying to control my feelings for you, you know, trying to keep it professional, you know?
Well, I appreciate that, Brian. I really do.
Well, hey, listen, if you ever change your mind, you know, you want to go for a drink or something, just know where to find me.
Yeah, I know where to find you. So take it easy.
Yeah, I almost forgot. Listen, you were on that grow-up call this morning, right?
Yeah, a couple of skinheads beat and raped the tenant. One of them died.
Yeah, you know, I heard something on that. This kid I got on the hook, right? He's going to fill me in with the details. You want to go for a ride? We're meeting over in the East End.
Now? He's got something on the case?
Yeah, no, we're on our way. Well, she comes back with her lattes anyway.
Well, I got to let Homicide know.
No, well, I want to give this to you, my old partner, because you're my old partner. Right?
Well, I got to make the call to Homicide. You don't want to share the info, you explain it to him.
This is where the guy will be, okay? I'll warm him up for you.
Thanks.
Make sure Homicide knows where you got this, okay?
Yeah.
Thank you. You're welcome.
We're waiting for her daughter to arrive from Victoria. The son's in the hospital. She doesn't want to talk to anybody. Wouldn't let the doctor do the rape kit.
It is traumatic. She just wants it all to go away.
Yeah. I don't imagine she's going to want to get up in court and explain everything.
So this is an isolated incident?
Suki says she looked at the database, and this is the fourth one on record this past month. I mean, there's a lot of drug rip-offs going down all the time, but usually they don't get reported.
How are we doing with the second suspect?
Turns out they live together in Surrey, so we get the horsemen sitting on their place. See if that other guy turns up.
Okay, well, hook up with drug squad and see what kind of intelligence they've got. How are you two getting on?
Good. Yeah.
Yeah, no complaints.
Hey, Leo. You got a second?
Yeah.
Just wanted to talk to you. But this just stays between you and me, okay? Okay.
Okay.
I'm thinking about putting my name in for chief of police.
Yeah, that's a good one. Come on.
Seriously.
You serious?
Yeah, serious.
Well, I think you may be seriously underestimating the depth of animosity out there in certain quarters. You wouldn't make it past the first cut.
Oh, well, I appreciate your honesty.
What the hell would you want to go and take on something like that for anyway? You got a great setup right here.
Which reminds me to remind you that when you retire, keep me in mind as I need a good investigator from time to time. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I appreciate that. And I'm going to take that seriously.
Good.
I'm going to come collect on that one.
That offer's on the table anytime. I told you that before.
All right.
Okay. Any idea who else is going for that chief's job?
Well, I can check around and let you know.
Okay, good. No one has to know who's asking, right?
Hey, for all they're going to think, it's me that's going to be running for it, you know? We'll sit back there in the weeds, let the front runners tire themselves out.
Yep.
And then we'll come up quick in the home stretch.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Hey, Leo. Thanks.
He's in the back working the tables.
Supposed to hook up with Tim and Donnie last night, but Tim calls about one, says deal went sideways and not gonna be able to hook up.
What about Donnie?
He said Donnie had an accident, then he was going to the hospital.
End up talking to Tim again?
He said he'd come by tonight.
Here? What time?
Midnight, one, same as before.
Okay, well, when he leaves, I want you to point him out to us, okay? Sorry, I didn't hear you.
Okay.
Okay.
I do a lot of the church work, too.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, that's mostly what I do. The upkeep, look after the grounds, painting, repairs. You know, I'm a handyman.
Handyman? That's a lost art.
It is.
Well, I got a lot of stuff to do around my house, and I just can't seem to get to it.
Well, that's why you need the handyman.
So you were going to help Mrs. Ripley with her gutters, and then you realized something was wrong. Is that what happened?
That's right. I was knocking and knocking. Nobody was answering the door, so I didn't know if she was back in the hospital or what.
Mm-hmm.
I had my ladder up, so I took a look through the window and... Excuse me. Hello? Uh-huh. Can you smell the gas? Okay. Well, don't light any matches. Yeah, just open the door and the window. Yeah, well, put the dog on the leash, then open the door. Yeah, put the budgie out on the porch too, okay? Okay. I'll be there soon.
All right, shouldn't be too long here. So you went in the house to check on Mrs. Ripley. Now, did you do anything in there? Did you touch anything in there at all?
No, sir.
You didn't water the plants, did you?
Oh, well, I might have done that.
Oh, you might have done that. And I was smelling air freshener in there like lemon. I'm wondering if that was you, too.
Well, it was pretty rank in there. Yeah, that might have been me, too.
Okay, anything else?
No, sir.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so did you see a walker when you went into her bedroom? And if so, where was it?
The walker was right beside the bed.
And you moved the walker. Now, that's something else, isn't it?
Well, I guess I did.
I guess you did.
It was in the way there.
Well, okay. That's all right. You just look at this list for me. I got a list of other members of this congregation, this church here, who passed recently. Do you know any of these people?
Well, I know him.
Yeah.
And her. Her. And him. I know everybody.
It's pretty much everybody.
I did work for all of them.
Well, all these people passed in the last few months.
That's right, they did.
You remember, you noticed anything that they held in common, other than the fact that you worked for them?
Well, they all lived in the neighborhood.
Okay.
That's why I did work for them.
All right, anything else, though?
They were all pretty old.
Okay.
Yeah, you get problems running a grow up. You gotta have like a serious security system. Otherwise, somebody's gonna bust in.
No, our hydro's gonna twig. You see, they sent a thing out with the bill telling people how to spot a grow up now.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you gotta beef up the booby traps, send out warnings.
Yeah, that's the growers paying protection money. I think that's what happened with that lady getting raped there. It was just a big warning gone wrong.
They're closing. It's 1:30. This guy's a no-show.
It's probably that kid, Mitch. Bet he tipped him off. He's playing us both ways.
Got a pair from a friend.
Okay. Those are the new ones?
Yeah.
Okay. So did you make out your police report yet?
No, not yet.
I didn't think so, okay? I'm gonna get into it, okay? But you gotta make out that report.
I hate going to the police station unless I have to.
Well, you have to, okay? And you want me to help you out? Here's if you go and make the report, I'll walk over there.
I'm on my way.
What's the matter? Is something wrong?
I'm seeing double sometimes.
What do you mean?
It's glasses.
Double vision? You're seeing double?
Yeah, it's glasses. I ordered a new pair. These are just temporary.
Did you go and see the dog?
I'm on my way.
Just go to the police department, okay? I'll call you later.
Okay.
Then go see the dog.
Okay.
Gotta do it.
I said I'm on my way.
Why didn't the others get autopsy?
Why? Because they were all under care of their personal physicians when they died.
Did any of them have the same doctor?
Two of the five.
Just two?
Yeah.
But they all went to the same church.
Yeah, but I don't know how unusual that is. I mean, what does that say, really? That's quite common. They were all on the same home care meals program, though.
You say she'd soiled her bed.
Exactly.
She'd evacuated her bowels.
Right.
Well, maybe it was a foodborne virus. Botulism, maybe.
Yeah. Maybe it was. Okay, all right. This sabbatical of yours, that's happening pretty soon, isn't it?
Yeah, next week.
Did you get somebody to fill in?
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
So it's really happening.
She's great.
Well, it won't be you. We're going to miss you around here. You better stay in touch. Okay. You get back to me on that botulism?
Yeah. As soon as I know anything.
You won't forget?
Dr. Forbes is from the Ministry of Health. He wants to take a quick look around your kitchen, okay?
Okay, sure.
You prepare all the meals here?
Every morning. We have volunteers in at 5 cooking the breakfasts, and then they're delivered.
Who does deliveries? Takes the meals out to them?
More volunteers. We've had to expand our roster because there's been so many requests.
Oh, yeah. Now, Mrs. Ripley, she had her meals delivered once a week. Is that right?
That's right.
What's in here?
Oh, you name it. Everything. Meats, vegetables, donations from the local stores, individuals.
Okay. Well, doctor, I'll leave you to it.
Okay.
Let me know.
I will. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So the members of this congregation, are they getting regular visits? The ones who are elderly and the shut-ins and all that?
Whenever I can. We have an aging congregation, and quite a few of them are less ambulatory than they used to be. The ones who passed, they shouldn't have been left at home. They should have been left in extended care.
These men and women, then, well, it's half and half, isn't it? 3 men, 3 women. They're all in the home care program.
I believe so.
So who's doing deliveries? Who's on that list?
We have a volunteer group.
Oh, great. Well, I need to see names and numbers there. Is that okay?
Sure, I can get that for you.
Hey, Councilman.
How you doing?
All right. Listen, what's this about? I've got a council meeting this
afternoon. Yeah, hop in. Let's go for a ride.
I just told you, I have a council meeting.
Jump in.
How's the girlfriend, Brenda? That's her name, right?
Yeah, it's Brenda. She's fine.
She's keeping her nose clean, staying out of trouble?
Yeah. What's this about?
Oh, it's just a little short on cash. I could use a loan.
You want to borrow money? That's why you called? How much?
A couple hundred. I just keep coming up short at the end of the month. It's the craziest thing. I didn't know where to turn.
So what am I supposed to get out of all this?
Supposed to get out of all this? I'm grateful, for one. That, and you know, look, you're ever in a jam, you're in some trouble, you and your friend Brenda, you give me a call and I'm there. I'm like 24-hour road service, man. You call me, then I'm there.
I don't have that on me right now.
Tomorrow's fine. But honestly, all right, anything I can do for you, just let me know.
You remember Brenda's old boyfriend, Rick something?
Yeah, for sure.
Well, I want to know just how much of a criminal record he has. No, serious.
Well, I can find that out easy enough. I'll let you know tomorrow.
I want to find out just what kind of a character he is, you know?
Just like how bad he is, kind of thing.
Right.
Do you have trouble with him?
Just want to know his history.
Got trouble with him, man. See, that's another thing. Just let me know. I'll go have a talk with him.
He's fine.
You know this guy?
I don't know. You pull any ID off him?
Timothy Hawkins.
That's the name.
Took a couple in the head. You can have a look.
It's all right. I'll take your word for it. You got any tire treads or anything like that?
Yeah, we got them taped off over here. We know this guy. He's been involved in a couple of girl operas before.
A lot of that out here, I guess.
It's everywhere. Yeah, you see, you got some good tread right there. You know, a couple of footprints. It looks like two people maybe came around back of what could be a pickup truck, hauled them out, and dumped them.
Okay. Better start swapping files with you guys.
Heard this guy raped an old woman?
That's what it sounds like.
Got the address of the grow-op house right here and a list of other addresses.
Yeah, they probably all turn out to be grow-ops. You'll see.
Figure. I don't want to write these down, okay?
Sure.
You got a pen?
It's in the car.
I got one.
Cranberries. Homemade.
Cranberries?
Apparently. Somebody donated a batch. All your people got a jar or two as an extra treat at Christmas. They all use them at different times during the year.
So, okay, that's the source then, is botulism.
I think so.
What's this gonna do to the home care and meals program?
I'm shutting it down. Shutting it down until at least we can find out for sure what happened.
How long is that gonna take?
You tell me. We'll be in touch.
Thanks, Doctor.
You're welcome.
You know a Darcy Charlie?
Yeah, I just talked to her a while ago. She does the needle exchange at the Carnegie Center. Why?
The hospital called, said you referred her to emergency.
Yeah, I told her to go see a doctor. What was the matter?
She died, waiting in emergency. They think it was a stroke.
A stroke? I want the body. I want to do an autopsy.
Her next of kin have already picked her up. They're taking her back to the reserve for burial.
Ah, Jesus. Okay. We better get on the phones. Let's find out who they are. See if we can get in touch with somebody before it's too late here. Thanks, Helen.
Yeah.
Certain she died as a result of that assault at the needle exchange.
She never filed a police report. She never made it to the doctor to get her exam done. And I got no clue who the other witnesses even were.
So what about this other thing we talked over? Did you think about that? What about it? You gonna take a run at the chief's job?
Yeah, I think I'll do it.
Felt bad because I never liked him.
Hey. Hey, thanks a lot. Now, it just seems like I'm on my fourth or fifth call here this year. It's old folks dying at home. Everything's not quite right in there.
Well, you know what it is. It's the hospital cutbacks and extended care and all that crap. They send them back home, and guess what happens? They die.
Okay, that's the theory, Leo. I hope that's not the case here, but I don't know. It's worth taking a look. The older I get, the more suspicious I get. You know what I mean?
Who's taking care of this lady?
Not sure. We're trying to get hold of her doctor.
When's the last time anybody was in here?
We're trying to get hold of the gardener, too. He's the guy that found her, so.
Hey, Rose, you see a thermostat around there anywhere?
Yeah. Here we go.
What's it say?
75. She's old. She likes it warm.
That soil is still wet. There's no way, sitting on top of the radiator like that for a week, that could still be wet. So somebody had to be in here.
Where'd you pick that up?
I killed more plants than anybody.
Okay, you want to look in the bedroom? Rose? Morning.
Ooh. She used the walker, huh?
Yeah. She's partially paralyzed.
Well, so she places the walker over there in the corner and hops back into bed? I don't think so. Somebody moved that walker.
What's this medicine here?
Blood thinners. After a stroke, that prevents blood clots.
Can we take these covers off?
Oh, yeah, sure. I got my pictures.
Her feet haven't been cared for in a while. Her toenails are curling. I don't think she's been mobile either. Bed's soiled.
Well, if she was bedridden, that means somebody had to have moved that walker.
Yeah. Well, maybe nothing, but I'm glad to have the extra set of eyes on this. I'm going to send her into autopsy.
Could be she was just forgotten to death.
Don't even worry about that guy. We'll just go in there. Hey, Suki.
Hey.
Marla, Suki, you guys know each other, right?
Yeah, we went through training together. How you been?
Good. You?
Good.
Listen, Marla, you mind grabbing us a couple of lattes?
Sure. Anything to snack?
No, I'm good. You want coffee? Marla's good.
No, I'm good. Thanks.
Just working with her.
Well, your new partner's not working out? I thought you two were made for each other.
Oh, no, she's...
Make sure victim services gets here sometime today, okay? Geez, I called half an hour ago.
They're on their way.
Yeah, we'll tell them to step on it.
Hey, Angie. Mick.
Hey, Suki. What's going on? Hey, where's Brian?
I don't work with him anymore. I got bumped from vice up to robbery.
No kidding. Hey, congratulations on both counts. You must be thrilled leaving him behind.
Yeah, apparently there is a God after all.
So what's going on here?
Oh, it looks like a grow house rep. They got about 5 kilos of bud just ready to harvest. This lady, Tam Tam, she rents. Lives upstairs, says she doesn't know a thing about the grow up in the basement.
That's the usual response. Complete denial.
Flashlight?
So what went down?
Thanks.
About 3, 4 a.m. this morning, her back door gets kicked in. Her son, who lives with her, he catches a 2x4 in the head. He's in the hospital, hasn't regained consciousness. Who knows if he will or what kind of condition he's going to be in if he does.
You got a line on the landlord?
He lives in Hawaii. We're tracking him down.
How many guys?
2, sounds like. So they kick in the door upstairs here, conk the son, grab Tam, try to force her to give up the key, which she already said she didn't have. So they push her around a bit for that, and then, get this, decide to rape her.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, so they do their stuff. Then on the way out, they decide to give the basement one more try. They get the door open upstairs here. Come on down. Watch it. Stairs are steep.
Oh, I could smell it from here.
Yeah, it reeks. It was like flies to honey.
Yeah, they knew it was ripe, so somebody had inside information.
Nothing happens without somebody ratting out somebody else.
So there you go. Must have caught a hell of a jolt, scorched his boot, burned his hand there.
He raped that woman and stepped right into hell.
Yeah, he got his.
So it's a booby trap or what?
I called forensics to go over it. They're on their way. Should be safe for now. The hydro guy's already been here, secured the juice. See that water on the floor? That's an irrigation line that was leaking.
Yeah. Did she give you a description of the other guy?
Yeah, just like this one. Skinhead, mid-20s, white. I couldn't figure if this ranked as a homicide or what.
How you doing?
Yeah, okay. It's pretty ripe. You might want to hold your nose.
Really? How long has it been since somebody saw her?
Church, about a week ago.
A week.
Then apparently some friends from the congregation tried to phone, couldn't get through.
Oh.
It was the gardener who finally found her. He was working on the gutters here. Saw her through the window in bed, couldn't rouse her.
Is he still around?
No, he had to go do some other jobs, but I got his number.
Is she in here?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
It looks like she died pretty peacefully. Just kind of slipped away.
Blood thinners. Maybe she's a stroke victim. Walker. Maybe she had a...
She used the walker, huh?
Yeah. Yeah. She's partially paralyzed.
Well, so she places the walker over there in the corner and hops back into bed? I don't think so. Somebody moved that walker.
What's this medicine here?
Blood thinners. You know, after a stroke, that prevents blood clots.
No.
Can we take these covers off?
Oh, yeah, sure. I got my pictures.
Her feet haven't been cared for in a while. Her toenails are curling. I don't think she's been mobile either. Bed soiled.
Well, if she was bedridden, that means somebody had to have moved that walker.
Yeah. Well, maybe nothing, but I'm glad to have the extra set of eyes on this. I'm going to send her into autopsy.
Could be she was just forgotten to death.
Don't even worry about that guy. We'll just go in there. Hey, Suki.
Hey.
Marla, Suki, you guys know each other, right?
Yeah, we went through training together.
How you been?
Good. You?
Good.
Good.
Listen, Marla, you mind grabbing us a couple of lattes?
Sure. Anything to snack?
No, I'm good. You want coffee? Marla's good.
No, I'm good. Thanks.
Just working with her.
Well, your new partner's not working out. I thought you two were made for each other.
Oh, no, she's fine. She's great. Just, just looking at you. Really.
Thanks. I got some stuff.
Listen, I just wanted to tell you, the whole time I was working with you, I was always trying to control my feelings for you, trying to keep it professional,
Well, I appreciate that, Brian. I really do.
Well, hey, listen, if you ever change mind, you want to go for a drink or something, just know where to find me.
Yeah, I know where to find you. So take it easy.
Yeah, I almost forgot. Listen, you were on that that grow-up call this morning, right?
Yeah, a couple of skinheads beat and raped the tenant. One of them died.
Yeah, I heard something on that. This kid I got on the hook, right? He's going to fill me in with the details. You want to go for a ride? We're meeting over in the East End.
Now? He's got something on the case?
Yeah, no, we're on our way. Well, she comes back with her lattes anyway.
Well, I got to let Homicide know.
No, well, I want to give this to you, my old partner, because you're my old partner.
Well, I gotta make the call to homicide. You don't want to share the info, you explain it to him.
This is where the guy will be, okay? I'll warm him up for you.
Thanks.
Make sure homicide knows where you got this, okay?
Yeah.
Thank you. You're welcome.
We're waiting for her daughter to arrive from Victoria. The son's in the hospital. She doesn't want to talk to anybody. Wouldn't let the doctor do the rape kit.
It is traumatic. She just wants it all to go away.
Yeah. I don't imagine she's going to want to get up in court and explain everything.
So this is an isolated incident?
Suki says she looked at the database, and this is the fourth one on record this past month. I mean, there's a lot of drug rip-offs going down all the time, but usually they don't get reported.
How are we doing with the second suspect?
Turns out they live together in Surrey, so we get the horsemen sitting on their place.
See anything in there at all?
No, sir.
You didn't water the plants, did you?
Oh, well, I might have done that.
Oh, you might have done that. And I was smelling air freshener in there like lemon. I'm wondering if that was you, too.
Well, it was pretty rank in there. Yeah, that might have been me, too.
Okay, anything else?
No, sir.
Are you sure?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so did you see a walker when you went into her bedroom? And if so, where was it?
The walker was right beside the bed.
Then you moved the walker. Now, that's something else, isn't it?
Well, I guess I did.
I guess you did.
It was in the way there.
Well, okay. That's all right. You just look at this list for me. I got a list of other members of this congregation, this church here, who passed recently. Do you know any of these people?
Well, I know him.
Yeah.
And her. Her. And him. I know everybody.
It's pretty much everybody.
I did work for all of them.
Well, all these people passed in the last few months.
That's right, they did.
You remember, you noticed anything that they held in common, other than the fact that you worked for them?
Well, they all lived in the neighborhood.
Okay.
That's why I did work for them.
All right, anything else, though?
They were all pretty old.
Okay.
Yeah, you get problems running a grow-op. You gotta have, like, a serious security system. Otherwise, somebody's gonna bust in.
No, our hydro's gonna twig. You see, they sent a thing out with the bill telling people how to spot a grow-op now?
Yeah?
Yeah, so you gotta beef up the booby traps, send out warnings.
Right? Yeah, that's the growers paying protection money. I think that's what happened with that lady getting raped there. It was just a big warning gone wrong.
They're closing. It's 1:30. This guy's a no-show.
It's probably that kid, Mitch. Bet he tipped him off. He's playing us both ways.
Got a pair from a friend.
Yeah. Those are the new ones?
Yeah.
Okay. So did you make out your police report yet?
No, not yet.
I didn't think so, okay? I'm gonna get into it, okay? But you gotta make out that report.
I hate going to the police station unless I have to.
Well, you have to, okay? And you want me to help you out in this? And this is, if you go and make the report,
I'm on my way.
What's the matter? Are you getting something wrong with you?
I'm seeing double sometimes.
What do you mean?
That's glasses.
Double vision? You're seeing double?
Yeah, it's glasses. I ordered a new pair. These are just temporary.
Did you go and see the doc?
I'm on my way.
Just go to the police department, okay? I'll call you later.
Okay.
And go see the doctor.
Okay.
You gotta do it.
I said I'm on my way.
Why didn't the others get autopsy?
Why? Because they were all under care of their personal physicians when they died.
Did any of them have the same doctor?
Two of the five.
Bloody. Right, okay, I'll get a key made for you. Thanks. Dog walker.
You got a dog?
I got a puppy from the pound.
Oh, what kind?
He's a 57. Mostly terrier, I think. He's got that wiry kind of fur. The vet says they don't shed too much.
You hope. The mixes are the best, though. They're smarter.
Really?
How big?
I think he's going to be about, yay high. You can tell by their feet. He's going to be a little guy.
And my aunt had a little dog. Lap dog. Pick it up, it'd shake all over and pee on you. Bark at the TV, the walls, your shoes, anything.
Well, this guy's not going to be like that. He's really nice and quiet. That's why I picked him. Lucky, that's his name.
You name him?
No, that's what they were calling him down at the pound. He was scheduled to be put down, and then I showed up, so it fits. So your aunt's the little dog, and she still got him?
Oh, I got run over.
Oh. Gee, that's a shame.
Yeah. My aunt was really busted up about it, too. And then I felt bad because I never liked him.
Hey, thanks a lot. Now, it just seems like I'm on my fourth or fifth call here this year. It's old folks dying at home. Everything's not quite right in there.
Well, you know what it is. It's the hospital cutbacks and extended care and all that crap. They send them back home, and guess what happens? They die.
Okay, that's the theory, Leo. I hope that's not the case here, but I don't know. It's worth taking a look. The older I get, the more suspicious I get. You know what I mean?
Who's taking care of this lady?
Not sure. We're trying to get hold of her doctor.
When's the last time anybody was in here?
We're trying to get hold of the gardener, too. He's the guy that found her, so.
Hey, Rose, you see a thermostat around there anywhere?
Yeah, here we go.
What's it say?
75. She's old. She likes it warm.
That soil is still wet. There's no way, sitting on top of the radiator like that for a week, that could still be wet, so somebody had to be in here.
Where'd you pick that up?
I killed more plants than anybody.
Okay, you want to look in the bedroom? Rose? Morning.
Ooh. She used the walker, huh?
Yeah. Yeah, she's partially paralyzed.
Well, so she places the walker over there in the corner and hops back into bed? I don't think so. Somebody move that walker.
Professionally, huh?
Well, I appreciate that, Brian. I really do.
Well, hey, listen, if you ever change mind, you want to go for a drink or something, just know where to find me.
Yeah, I know where to find you. So take it easy.
Yeah, I almost forgot. Listen, you were on that that grow-up call this morning, right?
Yeah, a couple of skinheads beat and raped the tenant. One of them died.
Yeah, I heard something on that. This kid I got on the hook, right? He's going to fill me in with the details. You want to go for a ride? We're meeting over in the East End.
Now? He's got something on the case?
Yeah, no, we're on our way. Well, she comes back with her lattes anyway.
Well, I got to let Homicide know.
No, well. I want to give this to you, my old partner, because you're my old partner.
Well, I got to make the call to Homicide. You don't want to share the info, you explain it to him.
This is where the guy will be, okay? I'll warm him up for you.
Thanks.
Make sure Homicide knows where you got this, okay?
Yeah.
Thank you. Since you're welcome.
We're waiting for your daughter to arrive from Victoria. The son's in the hospital. She doesn't want to talk to anybody. Wouldn't let the doctor do the rape kit.
It is traumatic. She just wants it all to go away.
Yeah. I don't imagine she's going to want to get up in court and explain everything.
So this is an isolated incident?
Suki says she looked at the database, and this is the fourth one on record this past month. I mean, there's a lot of drug ripoffs going down all the time, but usually they don't get reported.
How are we doing with the second suspect?
Turns out they live together in Surrey, so we get the horsemen sitting on their place. See if that other guy turns up.
Okay, well, hook up with Drug Squad and see what kind of intelligence they've got. How are you two getting on?
Good.
Yeah?
Yeah, no complaints.
Hey, Leo. You got a second?
Yeah.
I just wanted to talk to you. This just stays between you and me, okay? Okay.
Okay.
I'm thinking about putting my name in for chief of police.
Yeah, that's a good one. Come
on. Seriously.
You serious?
Yeah, serious.
Well, I think you may be seriously underestimating the depth of animosity out there in certain quarters. You wouldn't make it past the first cut.
Oh, well, I appreciate your honesty.
What the hell would you want to go and take on something like that for anyway? You got a great setup right here.
Which reminds me to remind you that when you retire, keep me in mind, because I need a good investigator from time to time. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I appreciate that. And I'm going to take that seriously.
Good.
I'm going to come and collect on that one.
That offer's on the table anytime. I told you that before.
All right.
Okay. Any idea who else is going for that chief's job?
Well, I can check around and let you know.
Okay, good. No one has to know who's asking, right?
Hey, for all they're going to think, it's me that's going to be running for it, you know? We'll sit back there in the weeds, let the front runners tire themselves out.
Yep.
And then we'll come up quick in the home stretch.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Hey, Leo. Thanks.
Every once a week, is that right?
That's right.
What's in here?
Oh, you name it, everything. Meats, vegetables, donations from the local stores, individuals.
Okay. Well, Doctor, I'll leave it to her.
Okay.
Let me know.
I will. Thank you.
You're welcome.
So the members of this congregation, are they getting regular visits? The ones who are elderly and the shut-ins and all that?
Whenever I can. We have an aging congregation, and quite a few of them are less ambulatory than they used to be. The ones who passed, they shouldn't have been left at home. They should have been left in extended care.
These men and women, then, well, it's half and half, isn't it? Three men, three women. They're all in the home care program.
I believe so.
So who's doing deliveries? Who's on that list?
We have a volunteer group.
Oh, great. Well, I need to see names and numbers there. Is that okay?
Sure, I can get that for you.
Hey, Councilman.
How you doing?
All right. Listen, what's this about? I've got a council meeting this
afternoon. Yeah, hop in. Let's go for a ride.
I just told you, I have a council meeting.
Jump in.
How's the girlfriend, Brenda? That's her name, right?
Yeah, it's Brenda. She's fine.
She's keeping her nose clean, staying out of trouble?
Yeah. What's this about?
Oh, it's just a little short on cash. I could use a loan.
You want to borrow money? That's why you called? How much?
A couple hundred. I just keep coming up short at the end of the month. It's the craziest thing. I didn't know where to turn.
So what am I supposed to get out of all this?
Supposed to get out of all this? I'm grateful, for one. That, and, you know, look, you're having a jam, you're in some trouble, you and your friend Brenda, you give me a call, and I'm there. I'm like 24-hour road service, man. You call me, and I'm there.
I don't have that on me right now.
Tomorrow's fine. But honestly, all right, anything I can do for you, just let me know.
You remember Brenda's old boyfriend, Rick something?
Yeah, Rick, sure.
Well, I want to know just how much of a criminal record he has. Not serious.
Well, I can find that out easy enough. I'll let you know tomorrow.
I want to find out just what kind of a character he is, you know?
Just like how bad he is, kind of thing.
Right.
You have trouble with him?
Just want to know his history.
You got trouble with him, man. See, that's another thing. Just let me know. I'll go have a talk with him.
He's fine.
Okay, I'm coming, all right? All right, you're right there. Bye. Got my glasses? Oh, great.
Yeah, what happened to your other glasses?
Oh, listen, I'm expecting a really important fact from the mayor's office regarding possible safe injection sites.
Uh-huh.
What's this? Oh, great, that's it.
Yeah, that's a federal thing. You need the feds on board for that.
I know.
He said that the city can approve in principle when it comes to the distribution of a controlled substance. That's federal.
Well, no. There's no distribution going on. People are bringing their own dope. It's no different from needle exchange. I gotta take this. Well, who do I have to see?
Minister of Health, I guess. What happened to your other glasses?
I think there was somebody. Well, can I get right in there and see the minister? We must know somebody in there.
Yeah, okay. I'll get on it.
Okay.
So, hey, what brought the mayor around?
What?
Well, how come he's back in the injection sites now?
Oh, I don't know. I'm just glad he is, though.
Well, maybe he's not going to run again.
I don't know. He never said anything to me about running.
All right.
Not
well,
running or anything. What's that?
This is the list of directors on the police board.
Excellent.
You need those.
I need it. Thank you, Helen. Excellent.
You're welcome. Bye-bye.
Oh, I'll read anything if I can't sleep.
What turned you onto this stuff? What's it called?
It's called The Narrow Road to the Deep North. Basho. He was a poet in Japan. 1600s. And anyway, he lost his house in this fire, right? He lost everything in it. And he suddenly realized that the only thing he had left was himself. And he thought, he got this idea that if he walked far enough, maybe he could lose that too. So he walked and he walked maybe a couple hundred miles all over Japan, visited different monasteries, things like that, and then he wrote about it.
And did he? Well, did he ever lose himself?
I don't know. I haven't finished it yet. Got lost on the road a couple times. I guess that's losing yourself.
Yeah, I guess it is. My brother was in a monastery.
Really?
Yeah, someplace in Idaho now. But I don't hear from them too often. They take a vow of silence.
You know, I'm thinking that's just about probably the hardest vow to keep.
Would be for me. I'm on the phone for 5 minutes, I hang up, it's an hour later.
Yeah, I don't like the phone too much. You can't see the people's eyes. You can't see their gestures. You don't notice all the tells and giveaways.
Hmm. Never thought about it. I guess you're right.
Letters are more intimate. People don't write letters anymore, though.
You write a letter, you get to edit yourself. That's not letting the person see your eyes right there.
I haven't written a letter in a long time, man. I used to have a pen pal in Mexico.
Yeah? I had a pen pal in Greece. I was wondering what happened to her.
Mine started asking me for money, so I started loading up the quarters into the envelope, sending in my allowance, right? And the old man came in and caught me doing it one day, and that was just about all I wrote.
Someone's gonna be by to talk to you real soon, all right? I'll be right back, okay?
Make sure Victim Services gets here sometime.
You gotta have, like, a serious security system. Otherwise, somebody's gonna bust in.
No, our hydro's gonna twig. You see, they sent a thing out with the bill telling people how to spot a grow up now?
Yeah.
Yeah, so you gotta beef up the booby traps, send out warnings.
Yeah, that's the growers paying protection money. I think that's what happened with that lady getting raped there. It was just a big warning gone wrong.
They're closing. It's 1:30. This guy's a no-show.
It's probably that kid, Mitch. Bet he tipped him off. He's playing us both ways.
Got a pair from a friend.
Yeah. Those are the new ones?
Yeah.
Okay. So did you make out your police report yet?
No, not yet.
I didn't think so, okay? If you'll leave, I'm gonna get into it, okay? But you gotta make out that report.
I hate going to the police station unless I have to.
Well, you have to, okay? And you want me to help you out? Here's, and this is, if you go and make the report, I'll walk
you
over.
No, I'm on my way.
What's the matter? Are you getting something wrong with you?
I'm seeing double sometimes.
What do you mean?
It's glasses.
Double vision? You're seeing double?
Yeah, it's glasses. I ordered a new pair. These are just temporary.
Did you go and see the doc?
I'm on my way.
Just go to the police department, okay? I'll call you later.
Okay.
Then go see the doc.
Okay.
You gotta do it.
I said I'm on my way.
Alright.
Why didn't the others get autopsy?
Why? Because they were all under care of their personal physicians when they died.
Did any of them have the same doctor?
Two of the five.
Just two?
Yeah.
But they all went to the same church.
Yeah, but I don't know how unusual that is. I mean, what does that say, really? That's quite common. They were all on the same home care meals program, though.
You say she'd soiled her bed.
Exactly.
She'd evacuated her bowels.
Right.
Well, maybe it was a foodborne virus. Botulism, maybe.
Yeah. Maybe it was. Okay, all right. This sabbatical of yours, that's happening pretty soon, isn't it?
Yeah, next week.
Did you get somebody to fill in?
Yeah.
You did?
Yeah.
So it's really happening.
She's great.
Well, it won't be you. We're gonna miss you around here. You better stay in touch. Okay. You get back to me on that botulism?
Yeah, as soon as I know anything.
You won't forget?
Dr. Forbes is from the Ministry of Health. He wants to take a quick look around your kitchen, okay?
Okay, sure.
You prepare all the meals here?
Every morning. We have volunteers in at 5 cooking the breakfasts, and then they're delivered.
Who does deliveries? Takes the meals out to them?
More volunteers. We've had to expand our roster because there's been so many requests.
Oh, yeah. Now, Mrs. Ripley, she had her meals delivered once a week. Is that right?
That's right.
What's in here?
Oh, you name it, everything. Meats, vegetables, donations from the local stores, individual.
The older I get, the more suspicious I get. You know what I mean?
Who's taking care of this lady?
Not sure. We're trying to get hold of her doctor.
When's the last time anybody was in here?
We're trying to get hold of the gardener, too. He's the guy that found her, so.
Hey, Rose, you see a thermostat around there anywhere?
Yeah, here we go.
What's it say?
75. She's old. She likes it warm.
That soil is still wet. There's no way, sitting on top of the radiator like that for a week, that could still be wet, so somebody had to be in here.
Where'd you pick that up?
I killed more plants than anybody.
Okay, you want to look in the bedroom? Rose? Morning.
Ooh. She used the walker, huh?
Yeah. She's partially paralyzed.
Well, so she places the walker over there in the corner and hops back into bed? I don't think so. Somebody move that walker.
What's this medicine here?
Blood thinners. You know, after a stroke, that prevents blood clots.
Can we take these covers off?
Oh, yeah, sure. I got my pictures.
Our feet haven't been cared for in a while. Our toenails are curling. I don't think she's been mobile either. Bed soiled.
Well, if she was bedridden, that means somebody had to have moved that walker.
Yeah. Well, maybe nothing, but I'm glad to have the extra set of eyes on this. I'm going to send her into autopsy.
Could be she was just forgotten to death.
Don't even worry about that guy. We'll just go in there. Hey, Suki.
Hey.
Marla, Suki, you guys know each other, right?
Yeah, we went through training together. How you been? Good. You? Good. Good.
Listen, Marla, you mind grabbing us a couple of lattes?
Sure. Anything to snack?
No, I'm good. You want coffee? Marla's good.
No, I'm good. Thanks.
Just working with you.
Well, your new partner's not working out? I thought you two were made for each other.
Oh, no, she's fine. She's great. Just, I'm just looking at you. Really.
Thanks. I got some stuff.
Listen, I just wanted to tell you, you know, the whole time I was working with you, you know, I was always trying to control my feelings for you, you know, trying to keep it professional, you know?
Well, I appreciate that, Brian. I really do.
Well, hey, listen, if you ever change your mind, you know, you want to go for a drink or something, just know where to find me.
Yeah, I know where to find you. So take it easy.
Yeah, I almost forgot. Listen, you were on that grow-up call this morning, right?
Yeah, a couple of skinheads beat and raped the tenant. One of them died.
Yeah, you know, I heard something on that. This kid I got on the hook, right? He's going to fill me in with the details. You want to go for a ride? We're meeting over in the East End.
Now? He's got something on the case?
Yeah, no, we're on our way. Well, she comes back with her lattes anyway.
Well, I got to let Homicide know.
No, well, I want to give this to you, my old partner, because you're my old partner, right?